ערב טוב נשים יקרות, good evening dear women.
Good evening.
You know there are some places I go they would start ערב טוב נשים. I ask them if at night they also say that. So ערב טוב נשים יקרות. Let's bless בעזרת השם שיגיע המשיח צדקנו במהרה בימינו אמן. שיגיע מבשר אליהו הנביא, אליהו התשבי, אליהו גלעד במהרה משיח בנביא, אליהו נביא זכור לטוב בעזרת השם. So we are going to continue Bezrat Hashem. Leda, the birth, you remember we stopped at, because it was a while ago, we stopped at birth, death, and resurrection, dear women. So we are still in birth. We're going to have two more lessons about it. And then Bezrat Hashem, we're going to go to Lo Aleinu LeDeath, the part that we transfer from this world to the true world, dear women. Olam HaChaim, to the world of life. So dear women, this, first of all, this parasha, this week, the parasha is Parashat Ki Tisa. This is about the Chet HaEgel, dear women, the sin of the golden calf. And we have also Parashat Parah, because you remember I told you there are four Shabbatot from... So this Shabbat, we read also Parashat Parah. We take out two books of Torah from the Heichal, and one of them we read Ki Tisa. And you will see, this is a long parasha, and you will see, dear women, that the Leviim, they read the part of the sin of the golden calf. Please go to TorahAnyTime.com. I think they have over that my lesson for Parashat Ki Tisa, and see the lesson over there. I would like to tell you, the Levi reads about this sin. Why? Because the Leviim were not part of the sin. So they are the ones that read this sin. So you will see that the part of Levi, Kohen veLevi, is a long part, and all Israel is a short part. It's all because that the children of Israel won't be embarrassed. So the Levi reads it because the Leviim were not part of the sin. And Parashat Parah, dear women, this is the atonement, part of the atonement for Chet HaEgel, for the sin of the golden calf. So dear women, we have it from Parashat Chukat, Bechumash Bamidbar, dear women. And the Haftarah of Parashat Parah is from Yechezkel HaNavi, the prophet Yechezkel. So I gave lessons, I think it's also recorded, it's also on the internet about Parashat Parah. Go to it and look, it's a Parashat Chukat, but I think I even gave it a title as Parashat Parah. So this is this week, Baruch Hashem. Next week will be Be'ezrat Hashem. Shabbat Abba is going to be Shabbat HaChodesh, Parashat HaChodesh, because it's the blessing of the month of Nisan. And the week after that, you will see on Tuesday, it's Rosh Chodesh Nisan. So this is approximately what's going on. After that, it's Passover. So we already start to clean, dear women. Now I would like to remind you a few things before we start. I would like just a small... Oh, excellent, excellent. So close to me, Baruch Hashem. Dear women, this is important. You remember we spoke about it, that we are all... we are all created out of letters. You want to see the Yud? You want to see, everybody wants to see, you want to see the Yud?
Okay.
Okay, it's the face and the throat. Do you see the Yud? Do you see the Yud? The face and the throat. Oh, in a minute I'll show you how Aleph looks like. In a minute I will be an Aleph. Wait. You see the Yud. You see the Shin? You see the Shin? You see, you cannot, you see the Dalet, nachon? We are all out of letters. We cannot see that. I told you, you remember that Klipat Noga has three shells. It has jealousy, lust, and honor. Take human being out of this world. And jealousy, lust, and honor. Take a human being out of this world. Jealousy can be positive and negative, but we'll come to it in Tomer Dvora. Lust, ze ta'ava. Akina ta'ava va'kavod motzin et adam min ha'olam. So dear women, we do not be... Now that I'm teaching you birth, you remember we spoke about it, how the angel protects the fetus and how the child comes to this world, dear women. And then we started speaking about a mahut, about the essence of a human being in this world. It's his name. Because the tubes of prosperity are the name comes from the name of a human being. When a person is sick, lo aleinu, it means that instead of these, that those tubes of asperity of his name that is upon above him, dear women, will be out of mercy, shalom, and that everything is judgment. That's why sometimes a person needs to add a name to himself or to add a letter to his name. Or to add a letter to his name, dear women. I know it's after Purim, and it's a little bit... So, dear women, you understand that, God forbid, we need to change this in order that always there will be mercy upon us from the tubes of the letters of our name. Now, dear women, look. It says, Bechesed Avraham, Bemidrash Talpiot, it says that Briat Gufu Neshama, the creation of the body and the soul, Guf Nefesh Ruach Neshama, Asher Lo Nivru Al Yedei Chafbet Otiyot HaTorah, which means they were only created by the 22 letters of the Torah, which means the soul, all the parts of the soul, Neshama, Ruach, and Nefesh, all of them. And I already told you by Rabbi Chaim Vital, you remember we spoke about it, that the Neshama has 22 letters, but they are big letters, the Aleph Bet letters, and the Ruach has 22, the 22 letters of the Aleph Bet, but they are medium size, and the Nefesh are the small ones. If we have the merit, we have all parts, all three parts of the soul that are in this world, all of them with us, and the letters are shining. If we do not have the merit, if we transgress, God forbid, or do a sin, the letters run away from us, the Neshama goes back, it's not covering us. It's still connected, but it's not covering us anymore. The Ruach also, yes. The Ruach also goes, and we have only the Nefesh that is in the blood, Ki Adamu HaNefesh, that is in the blood, in the liver, dear women, that cleans the blood, and only the small 22 letters of the Hebrew Aleph Bet. So listen what it says over here, Bemidrash Talpiot. וכל אחד מהם יש לחף בית אותיות התורה, והם בפנים של אדם, באור האדם שזכך אותם. It's inside our skin, the letters. ממש, inside. It's inside our body. We are created. We cannot see that. But if we were pure enough, we would have seen those letters. We would have seen how we are created out of letters. It's in our skin. So you remember, listen, you remember that the first human being sinned, and because of that, he had leather covering him. Oh, you're giving them paper? So, dear women, you remember that because of that, at the beginning, he was shining, he had light. Oh. No, the first human, I'm speaking about Adam, the first human being. He had big light coming out of him. But this changed when the soul was not giving this light and the skin was seen. So from Aleph, he changes to Ein. Look what happens. What is our fixing to change the Ein back to Aleph? Leor. Or is light, the or is skin. You see the Ayin and the Aleph? You remember Bemusaf Shel Sukkot, dear women. We give, when the temple was built, dear women, and Bezrat Hashem Yibaneh B'Merah B'Yameinu Amen, there are 70 sacrifices of animals against 70 nations. Why do the nations make problems towards the children of Israel? Because we changed the Aleph to Ayin, dear women. You see it over here? And then there's one sacrifice again, that is parallel to the children of Israel because they are parallel to Hashem. They are the firstborns of Hashem. That's why Avraham Avinu says, V'anochi afar v'efer. He says, I am doing the fixing. You see the Ayin? I'm doing the fixing of the first human being because afar means ayin, 70 numerical value of parim, of cows, of cattle, that is given against the, it's not against, kilu, the word against is parallel to the 70 nations, and then the children of Israel, that are the firstborn of Hashem. You see, this is the Aleph, which is the numerical value 1, and Par, cattle over here. So only one for the children of Israel, because they are his firstborns. And this is against the... So Avraham Avinu is already doing the... did the fixing of the first human being with Ayin and Aleph. We are doing the same thing now. We need to cause our skin to shine. Rabbi Meir Baal HaNes was called Meir because he was shining. You couldn't look at him. Elisha Navi, Elisha the prophet, which was the student of Eliyahu Navi, was shining. You couldn't look at him. Moshe Rabbeinu, Bekaran on Or Panav. Moshe Rabbeinu was shining. Nobody could. He had to put something on his face because they couldn't look at him. Look at, think about it. You know, at the end of days, when God is going, it says that all of the wicked people are going to die forever. They're not going to come anymore. All those souls. But you know how they're going to go out of this world? Only by the light of God. The light of God will be so shiny, so bright, that only the righteous can look at it, and the people that are not righteous cannot. They will be distinguished. This is the power of... It's like you're going to a dark room and then immediately you have big light. So your eyes cannot even catch it. You know, light, immediately light from a dark room. You're sitting for hours in dark. You go out, you cannot... Your eyes cannot see this light. This is the same thing. So dear women, we can see over here that it says that we could see, if we could have seen the letters inside that are shining from our skin even. Dear women, so let's continue. Dugmat masach harakia. Ve'omnam hatzadikim yesh benafsham la'ir mitoch ha'or shebefanav ve'lachutz. The righteous ones, they have the power to cause their letters to shine out from the light of their face, mamash. You see it from their skin out, outside, it says. Ve'la'avor ha'otiyot derech ha'or. So you can see the letters through the skin. בהתגלות לעין הזוכה לראות מן האותיות הפנימיות, וזהו עניין שהיו ראשונים רואים כתוב בעבירות שבמצח האדם. This is why the truly righteous people could have known what kind of עבירות, what kind of sins, transgressions a person did by looking at his forehead, because over there all the transgressions are written, all the sins are written on the forehead. Exactly. What letters we damaged. Everything is on the forehead. That's why when God gave the last plague to Egypt, the plague of killing the firstborn, he told the children of Israel not to go out of the house. Because once the angel, the bad angel is outside, he does not distinguish between good and bad, because King Solomon says there's no good person, that righteous person that will do good on earth and won't sin. You understand?
Let the word Zechira means.
Oh, I had a special lesson about it.
Oh, okay.
Zechira means to remember. Zechira.
Not the look.
No, Zechira is a remembrance. But I gave but it only in Hebrew. Yes, I gave a special, a whole lesson about forgetfulness and a remember.
Like my father used to do.
Sorry. No, because we had over here, you remember? We had parties over here. So I couldn't give it because it was a serious lesson. I had to have the board. And so I had to give it Dvar Torah that fits the party that we had. Baruch Hashem. So dear women, so righteous, really righteous people can see the letters on the forehead. And when there's a plague, we have to stay at home. Why? Because the bad angel does not distinguish between a good person and a wicked person. Because all of the sins of a person is written on his forehead. So he sees it. He sees the letters on the forehead. And King Solomon says, there's no righteous person that will do good and won't sin, dear women. So now let's continue. Now that I told you all of this, we are going to continue. And I want to explain something. Dear women, you know... Each and every one of us that came to this world, God does not bring a person to this world in coincidence. Which means that each and every one of us has a purpose. He has a duty in this world, a specific duty that he needs to do. Mamash, kol echad yesh lo tafkid miyuchad. It's a specific, nobody can do what he needs to do. So, which means, if shal evater alav, We cannot give him up. No one in this world. Each and every one of us, now that we came and we are sitting together, we have each... This is why we... Jealousy is nonsense. Because if we understand that each and every one of us has a special duty, nobody can go into the duty of a person. Yeah, but it's not only a journey. It's something that he needs to do to other people and to help them with their fixing and to help himself and the ones that are in the true world already. So do you understand? So there's no point of jealousy. Nobody can take anyone's place in this world. Ein malchut nogad b'malchut, which means there's no kingdom touching any kingdom. Each and every one of us is a whole kingdom. A whole world. It's a whole kingdom. Each and every one of us. So jealousy, bad jealousy, comes from the evil inclination, dear women. Mamash. Because the evil inclination wants separation. Look at the world today. There's so much hatred and false hatred. People don't even know why they dislike people. People do not know. If you'll ask, I'm sure if you'll go and ask people who hate Jewish people, I'm sure they don't even know why they truly hate Jewish people. Yeah. The evil inclination wants separation and wars. Today, Satan is dancing all over. He has reason to dance because the hatred, jealousy, control over power, money, lust, it's all over wherever we go, mamash, and in such measures, Baruch Haba, welcome, in such measures that you cannot believe it. So this is mamash, a dance of the evil inclination in between all of us. So now let's see, what is our duty? I told you that a part of our duty is to take, most of our duty is to take the ayin, okay, in the Hebrew Aleph Bet, the or, which is the skin, and to turn the ayin of the or to Aleph, the first letter of the Hebrew Aleph Bet, which means light. Now let's look. You know, the letters, all of them came from the first letter of the Hebrew Aleph Bet, which was the Aleph. Now I would like to tell you something. What is the Aleph? Shh, listen, Banot. What is the Aleph? You'll see it. I will show you how Aleph looks. Do you see? Aleph looks like this. You see, I cannot stand. Do you see the Aleph? You see? You see the Aleph? You see the Vav? I cannot stand like this. You can see Malachsam. But just see the Yud. You see over here? And another Yud. You see the Aleph? Okay. This Aleph, you know, everything in the Kabbalah, but Pardes, is out of three lines. Three lines. A line of mercy, Kav Shel Chesed, and then there's a line of, chesed we'll call kindness, okay? Well, let's call it names. And then we have kav shel rachamim. Rachamim is mercy. And then we have another kav, another line, dear women, of judgment. So we have three lines. We have kindness, we have mercy, and we have judgment. Three lines. Now look, three lines, everything by the Kabbalah, by the counts of the Kabbalah. Look at the Aleph again. So what do we see? The Aleph receives from high places, from Hashem, you see? And then where does the Aleph give? Over here. To us. You see? The Yud over here comes over here. So it gives us. Think about it. And the Vav over here. Beta, chayav lavo, v'gam ilemata lemala. Ki kshesh itarut adiltata, yesh itarut adilela. Which means when we awaken over here to do tshuva to Hashem, there's also awakeness in heavens. You understand? It has to be. It's an equilibrium, dear women. Both ways. But the wisdom of God comes from heaven. So the yud over here is the yud from on the right side. This is the chesed. Okay? This is the kindness. This is the yud from the left side. The left side is judgment. Yishar koach, the judgment. I'm going to say, yishar koach. What? Dear women, and then the vav is the line of mercy. This is the lama because it's written. Shh. Yeah, I told you it will take. I wanted. Well, I hope Bezrat Hashem. The vav is the mercy. Zerachamim. This is the vav. Lama ki ketuv ish tam yoshev oalim. It's written about Yaakov Avinu. That he is a modest person who sits between the tents. What tense? So this is Yaakov Avinu, the Vav, the tent of Avraham Avinu and the tent of Yitzchak. Lama Avraham worshipped Hashem in the measure of kindness. Yitzchak worshipped Hashem in the measure of judgment. And Yaakov Avinu was in between those two measures, which means part of kindness, part of judgment, with its mercy. Without this line, there's no peace between mercy and judgment. This line causes peace. Peace, shalom, is the name of God. So now we have it in our imagination, now in our heads, how it looks like, dear women, okay? So we have all of it. So let's go. You remember that last... Yes?
You just said, if without the middle, there's no...
Peace between kindness and judgment.
Kindness and judgment.
Yes. Okay. This is the mercy. This causes peace between me. It has to be three lines. לכן כתוב עושה שלום במרומיו ובחמיו עושה שלום עלינו ועל כל ישראל. He, God, who does peace in heavens. If you have a question, I'll answer it.
What is the middle?
Mercy.
Mercy,
okay? So he, I know it's a little bit hard, I can just ask me and I will repeat it. So it says about Hashem, that Hashem that does peace in heaven will do peace on earth, which is very weird. In heaven, they don't have evil inclination. There's no reason to peace. There should be always, there should... אין להם יצר הרע? מלאכים. אין להם יצר הרע למלאכים. יש לכל אחד תפקיד. They have duties, but they don't have evil inclination.
אז איזה שלום
יש למעלה? הנה, עכשיו אני אומרת לכם, הנה, תקשיבו, בנות. The peace, that's why we need peace. Why even in heaven? Because even in heaven, there's esh v'maim, which means fire and water. You remember how was the earth created and shamaim were created. Okay? וכי לוקחים אש ומים, okay? לוקחים אש ומים ולוקחים את השין של האש ומחברים למים, זה שמיים, dear women. I'll show you over here. We take ash, water, fire, sorry, and maim. We take the shin of the fire and we add it to maim. We have shamaim, we have skies. You see? And the aleph goes to eretz. Okay? Why? Because the earth wanted to, she was running, like running to do in order to do what God wanted her to do. So we add the aleph to ratz and we have eretz. So we have peace ben esh, ben maim, ben water and fire, dear women. So let's go another step. We spoke about good name. You remember that it's very important. So I wanted to tell Parashat Truma, the Parashat Truma that we read 2 weeks ago, it says over there about four things. It says Aaron, it spoke about the ark, which you know the Torah was inside, which the tablets were inside. And then it spoke about the table, and it spoke about the Mizbeach, the altar, and it spoke about the menorah, the light, okay, the light of the menorah. Dear women, we can see במשנה, מסכת אבות, רבי שמעון says, there are three crowns. רבי שמעון אומר, שלושה כתרים, there are three crowns. כתר תורה, the crown of Torah, כתר כהונה, the crown of priesthood, כתר מלכות, the crown of kingdom, כתר שם טוב עולה על כולם, and כתר of good name is above all of them. So let's look. We have the Aaron is parallel. The Aaron is the ark. It's parallel to Keter Torah, the crown of Torah. And then we have the table, which is parallel to the crown of kingdom. That, because it's a table of kings, we say. So it's parallel to kingdom. And then we have the altar, which is parallel to priesthood, because only the priests go and give sacrifice on the altar. And then we have the menorah. And the menorah that lights is the Keter of Shem Tov. We'll explain it. I'm just giving you things. We're going to go to the menorah and explain it, how this is the Keter of Shem Tov. So this is the Keter of Shem Tov. So let's go another step. Keter Shem Tov, because King Solomon says, Tov Shem Tov mi Shemen Tov. He says in Kohelet, it's better to have a good name than a good oil. This is very weird a little bit, the comprehension that we compare those two. Yes. It says, Tov Shem Tov mi Shemen Tov, Yom HaMavet mi Yom Ilvado, and the day that you die from the day that you were born. This is the sentence from Kohelet. Why does the day that you die is better than the day that you are born? So I'll explain to you, dear women, because but when we are born, we don't have any mitzvot. We didn't do anything yet. But when we die, Be'ezrat Hashem, I hope that we go with sacks and carriages of good deeds and commandments that we follow in this world. That's why it's better the day that you pass away than the day of that you are born. I hope for all of us that this is true, Be'ezrat Hashem. Amen. And now, why does Shem Tov, why does King Solomon compare a good name to an oil? So I would like to show you. You remember that I told you that a person, while he's born in this world, he starts to write his book. How does he write his book? He writes his book by filling the letters of his name. Okay, so let's fill the letters of Shemin. This is oil in Hebrew, and I'm filling the letters, okay? You remember how we did it last time. It's Shin, so I write it like I hear it, Shin, okay? And then the Mem, and then the Nun, okay? Here, I'm filling it. How many letters do I have over here? I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, okay? Which means the Chet. If we have the merit, we are above nature. We have miracles above nature. Okay, and the oil is Shemen HaMishcha. Oil is also the oil that they made kings. You remember, you put like King David. You remember that Shmuel HaNavi, the prophet Shmuel, and David came, and the oil went on by himself from the hands of Shmuel HaNavi, the prophet, and was poured over King David, and precious stones came out of it, over the head of King David. Mamash ad kedei kach, ki ze Mashiach ben David. So this is the Shemin. And so let's look what is hidden in the Shemin, in the oil. So if I look at Shemin, I can see that it's Shem, okay, and Nun. Which means this is a name, ki nefesh chaya hu shmo. Shem, you see? Shem, name, and Nun. 50 gates of wisdom. You see? If a person has the merit, he can, from his name, receive 50 gates of wisdom. You see it over here? Shem, Nun. You see the Shem Po over here? Okay, let's continue. Because the highest that we have is 50 gates of wisdom. Okay? 50 Sharei Bina. You remember the children of Israel were in 49 gates of impurity? The ones that went into the 50th gate of impurity did not go out of Egypt. You remember that? The 50th gate is the gate of Evunah, of belief in Hashem. So let's continue. Now look at this. I'm taking out, you see the Shin, I'm taking out the word Shemin. Only the first letters of each word over here. What is left over? I have Yud and Nun and a Mem over here and Vav and Nun. So let's look at it. In numerical value, Yud is 10, Nun is 50, do the calculation. Mem is 40, and we have over here Vav is 6. And another Nun is 50. How much do we have here? 156. You know who is 156? This equals Yosef. Look, Pei is 80, Samech is 60, Vav is 6, Yud is 10. How much is it? 156. You know what is also 156? Kinah. Aleph is 1, Hey is 5. 156. So Kina, jealousy, is also 156. You remember, on Parashat Yechi, Yaakov Avinu blessed Yosef HaTzadik, Ben Porat Yosef. You remember, all his blessing, when we to knock on wood, we say Ben Porat Yosef. Because of the blessing that Yosef received from his father, Yaakov. This is the close of the word shemen, oil. The hidden letters, the numerical value of them is 156, which is jealous. A parallel to Yosef HaTzadik, which is Yetzadik. So let's look at, this is a fixing. You see the shemen? Let's look, dear women, and add the shin, mem, and nun. 300. Mem is 40. Nun is 50. Okay, how much do we have? 309. This is what we have, Nachon? What? How much do we have? We 6. I'll wipe only this, because I want the jealousy to stay here. Word Israel. Yud is 10 in numerical value, Shin is Shlosh. Is 1, and Lamed is 30. How much is it? 5. We have in the word Israel 5. Plus 5. We have Shashemen. Hakol nimtza betoch hamila shemen. Which are his firstborns. Nations, including the Jewish, that the Jewish people are his firstborns, and like special duty, because they towards Hashem. All the forefathers and mothers. Rachel, Berivka, the Aleph is Efa Tilim.
Okay, go. So, dear women, both names, Yaakov and Israel, together is parallel, it's equals, dear women, to Krasotan, to tear off Satan from the children of Israel. We say that this is the name out of the 42 names of God for Monday. Okay? Yes. You know the name, Anna Bekoach, dear women? As Kabel Rinat Amecha Sagvenu Ta'arenu Nora, the first letters of all these words. Ah, Krasotan. It's for Monday, dear women. It's out of the 42 names of God. So let's continue. So you see that the oil, that's why it says, Tov Shem Tov Mishemen Tov, which means the name is the book that we are writing for ourselves. We are filling the letters of our name like a pyramid. The more we do good deeds and the commandments of Hashem, we follow them, the more our book is filled. Once we transgress, we do a sin, and we don't understand why we are here, dear women, and it does not matter if we think logically, if we think, well, show me, explain to me. The truth is we went through it for, in lessons that we already had. The truth is, whatever God told us to do, this is the truth. What he told us not to do, this is the lie, which means we are not allowed to do that. There's no question mark about it. So if all of us, as humanity, as a whole, if the children of Israel would have kept all of the 620 commandments, and the nations would have kept the 7 commandments of Noah, there will be heavens upon earth. Over here there will be heaven already. Because there wouldn't be any jealousy, there wouldn't be any lust, and there wouldn't be any seeking out, running after honor. So everybody would have been satisfied with what they have. This would be, this is the times of mamash of heaven.
Amen.
So let's look at it, dear women. So how do we fill our book? So I told you that the Aleph is the head of all of the letters. And if we take the Aleph out of the Aleph Bet, if we take the Aleph over here and I put it above the letters, I can divide the letters, you see over here, to three lines. Each line has seven letters. So I have seven multiplied by three, we have 21 letters, okay? Chaf Aleph. Chaf Aleph, nachon, 21. This is Chaf Aleph. This is the letter with the Aleph, it's 22. The 22 letters from Aleph Atah, the Hebrew letters. Now, dear women, it says בפרדס רימונים של רבי משה קורדוברו, dear women, that we are studying Tomer Dvorah. The first line from Bet to Chet, it's Kav, like this, it's the Kav of kindness. This is the line Kav Chesed. This is the line of kindness. Write it down, because then when you want to look at your name, this lesson and the next lesson, when you want to analyze your name, you can find the letters, where they come from. Kindness, judgment, mercy. So look, the second line from Tet Lesamech, this is Kav Rachamim. The third line from Ayin to Taf, this is Kav Dinim. This is the line of judgment. You see it over here?
Yeah.
Okay. Now let's look at the letters. Look how it's beautiful. You see, we're going to divide this upon the ten, upon the menorah, but in a few minutes. First, I want to go here. You see what I have over here?
Yeah.
I have the Aleph Bet. And this is a very special thing. If you look, if you pay attention, I divided it. The first nine letters, okay, from Aleph to Tet. And then I took from Yud to Tzadik. And then another line from Kuf to Tzadik Sofit. Okay, you remember there are 27, because we have Atate Tzaveh, Vayikach Elecha Shemin. We just spoke about the Shemin. You're going to command that God tells Moshe Rabbeinu, and that you're going to take to you an oil,
virgin oil.
Ken. Shemin Zayit.
Olive oil.
Zach. What is Zach? Zach means Zayin is 7, Kaf is 20, it's 27, the 27 letters of the Hebrew Aleph Bet. There are 22 from Aleph to Taf, and then we have Man, Sa, Paf. The letters that have end letters, there are 5, you see it over here? So together these 5, the 22 plus those 5, dear women, are 27. So you see Shem and Zach. Now you see the connection between the letters and the Shemin? You see it, Zach. But the most beautiful thing, I told you this week is Parashat Parah. So look at the letters over here. Mem, those end letters, those are very harsh letters. Those are letters of dinim, of judgment. You see, those are letters of judgment, all of these. The Sofiyot. Those letters, dear women, are the letters that Abraham Avinu knew their secrets, and with these letters we have redemption and salvation in every exile that we had. When we had the exile of Egypt, he said Pakod Ifkod. So what was the, it's the pay, Pakod Ifkod. You see? With the pay, with this, the end letter pay, with this, God helped us to go out of Egypt. And then Bezrat Hashem, Nachamu Nachamu Ami. Bezrat Hashem, this exile will be also with the letters Nun. Because the letter Nun over here, you see it? Nachamu Nachamu Ami. Give comfort to my people. These are secrets of the letters of God. I'm giving them just a touch. So look at this. We're speaking about Parashat Parah. Okay? So let's look, the mem in those 5 letters, that end letters, the mem, end letters, it means, and we have the open one, you remember the mem that is open, and then we have the mem that is closed.
We spoke about both of them, if you remember.
Yes.
We have the noon that is open, and we have the noon that is tuha, you see? Then the tzaddik, we have the tzaddik, and then we have the tzaddik that is ptucha. And then we have the pay, okay? We have the pay, and then we have the pay that is patua. You see? We have the chaf, and the chaf sheptucha, you see? There's only five letters. But now let's look at the numerical value of the letters. Okay? Let's look at the numerical value. So we have mem is 40, nun is 50, tzaddik is 90, pei is 80, and chaf is 20. How much do we have over here? We have 280. You know what 280 is? Pam. Resh is 200, pay is 80. You remember para, parashat para? So it's part of the fixing. You see it over here? What is also in the word para? We can take out pay. So what is the fixing of this generation against false hatred that we have in this world, mamash, like a fire in this world? It everywhere. So we have tikkun, the fixing of slandering, lashon hara, and we have the fixing of eating, achila, because everything is with a peh, and we have the fixing of mila. Brit mila zera levatala, the peh, the mouth. The fixing that is our generation's fixing is slandering. We have it all over the media. They're all over the media. It's unbelievable what's going on. Lies are called truth, and truth is called the lie. Mamash all over. Look, we just need to look around us. So we see the fixing of the mouth, which is lashon hara, slandering, and eating. How many people we have in the world that have overweight? They are women. רחמים וחסד אותה, היא כוללת את הכל, אמרת לכם את שלושה, לכל השלושה, שלושה קווים יש בה. The Aleph is part of all of three of them, because she has the three lines, the Aleph. That's why she is the tube of prosperity for all of the letters, from her all the letters are created. So dear women, look, and we have Mila, you know the Brit Mila, Mila, okay? Lama Mila, it's taking out sperm in vain. How do I know that it is also part of peh or mouth? Because dear women, mem is 40. Mem is 40. Yud, dear women, is 10. Lamed is 30. He is 5. How much is it? 85. Nachon? Peh is 80. He is 5. 85. You see it? It's in the secrets of the peh. So what did we come to fix? We came to fix Lashon Hara now, the time of Geula, Lashon Hara, slandering, we came to fix the eating. It has to be not only to eating too much, but more than that. It has to be when we eat, we have to bless Hashem. We have to ask permission from Hashem. The food has to be kosher. And we have to ask permission from, it's parallel to, if a person comes, a visitor comes to a person and visits him at home, and he won't ask him, he'll open the refrigerator, he'll take the food and he will start eating. And the host will say, what's going on here? This is very rude, you had to ask for me. So dear women, it's the same thing. This is the world of God, He created everything. We have to ask permission. How do we ask permission? By blessing before we eat. Why do we have the urge to eat? It's not obvious that we have the urge to eat. When we have the urge to eat, it means that we have a fixing to do. Mamash, you will see people that are very sick, they don't have any urge to eat anymore. Ein lahem cheshek le'achol. It's a merit to have a cheshek le'achol, to have a will to eat. A merit. It's so sad when you see a person that does not want to eat anymore. Lezari Arav, I saw a few people like this that they were telling me, you know, I don't have the will to eat. I don't want lo. Anashim sheyetzu ma'olam. They did not want the mamash to eat because there's no fixing anymore with the food. This is a fixing. When a human being eats from food, okay? So this food was wheat before. It jumps from wheat. You remember, because you remember that I told you there are four reincarnations. There's reincarnation in still things, domim, and there's reincarnation in plants, there's reincarnation in animal, and then there's reincarnation in the bersh, it's a human being. So if we eat and we bless and we truly thought about it, to think about Hashem, which means we are not blessing in order to eat, we are eating in order to bless. You understand the difference? Because if we are blessing in order to eat, it means we are hungry, Chachtam Shalosh will bless you, don't even think about the words we take out of our mouth.
Yeah.
But we do the opposite. We are going to eat in order to bless, which means I want to... There's a beautiful story about a rabbi that one of his Hasidim wanted to know. He was so holy, he wanted to know, what exactly does my rabbi do? I want to imitate him. I want to be like him. Mm-hmm. So he was with him all the Shabbat. And then on Motzei Shabbat, he's looking at him, and the rabbi takes an apple, and he cuts the apple, leplachim, so that he departs the apple. He looks at the apple, and he blesses, Borei Pri Haetz. So the Hasid thinks in his heart, what is very special about it? Everybody blesses. So the rabbi already knew what he was thinking. He told him, tell me, what do you see when you go out of the house? He tells him. So he says, well, I see, you know, there's the apple tree outside, there's this, he gives him a description of everything that he sees outside. Says, I want to tell you what I see. When I go out of the house, I see this beautiful apple tree that God created. Uh-huh. And I see the apples, how the colors, red and green, how beautiful they look. I see the shade that they give when people walk, and it's hot, and they stand underneath the apple tree. And when they are hungry, that they can take an apple and bless and eat. So I fill myself with love to Hashem, to His creation. Such love and such appreciation, gratitude to the creation of God. So you know what I do? I take all of this and I put it inside my heart, and I wait for the moment that I will take the apple, and I'm going to bless, and in the blessing I'm going to put all of this love to Hashem. That all of these words, because everything starts and ends with words, with letters, that all of these letters will have the shining and will be big and will go to heaven and give merit to all of the world. He says, this is the difference between your eating and my eating, because you eat. You bless in order to eat, and I eat in order to bless.
But it's also good to bless to eat.
עוד הפעם, ההבדל הוא, כשאדם הוא רעב, הוא אוכל בלי לחשוב על הברכה, אז זה נקרא שהוא מברך על מנת לאכול. כי את רעבה, אז את רוצה לאכול, את לא חושבת על הברכה. אבל ההבדל הוא, כשאדם אוכל על מנת לברך, זאת אומרת שכל המהות שלו זה הברכה. כל המהות, for example, I told you already, when we do סעודת המנים, when we eat מזונות, we should concentrate also on giving prosperity of income to the people, because mezonot is a blessing to have income for all the people that we know that need income. And all the children of Israel and all the world, that nobody will go hungry. And then, dear women, we have the gefen. When we bless over wine, it's a prosperity to get married. So we, in our thoughts, we bless. I bless this before even we say the blessing, or after we say the blessing, that with this blessing, Bezrat Hashem, those people will get married. And then when we bless etz, because you know a tree gives fruits, it's in order that women will have children. So all the women that have problem in giving children, it's, you know, it's in spirituality. Once we do that, we create mamash. You see the aleph. We create it, awakening from this world to awakening in the true world, in heaven. And we cause them to bless also the woman that we just thought about. And then when we have Adama, the first human being was created out of earth. So Adama is health, refuah shlema, to be healthy, to be cured. And then we have Shakol. Shakol is the fear of God and the love of God. It contains everything, because God created the world only by His speech. In ten speeches, God created the world. This is from Bereshit. So, dear women, you understand the value of the words we take out, the value of how we complete our book. This is our value. So let's go from this side, which you saw the three lines, and we'll go over here, dear women. Over here we can see that I told you divided it to 9, and we have 27 together, okay? But look what's very important over here. This is Aleph, Bet, Gimel, all of them. Let's start. Aleph is 1, Bet is 2, Gimel in numerical value is 3. So we have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then Yud is 10, okay? This is the line of all Achadot. Mm-hmm. Yud is 10, Chaf is 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. Kuf is 100. You see, this is the line of the tenths. This is the line of the hundreds. Kuf is 100, Reish is 200, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600, 700, 800, and 900. You see? And where is the thousand? How do you write thousand in Hebrew? Okay, I'll write it over here. Look over here. How do you write thousand?
Alafim.
A thousand we write elef. Elef. Okay,
Aleph.
Segol.
Aleph.
What is Aleph? Aleph. In different Nikud, Aleph, the first Hebrew letter. Aleph. You see it?
Yeah.
Ma ze Aleph? Tele. Tele. You see it? It's a miracle. Everything goes back to Aleph. You see it over here? Ki Aleph. You see, this is how you write Aleph. The first letter, you see Aleph? This is how you write it. With different nikud is Aleph. Which means after we finish 900, we go back to Aleph. You see the circle? Which means everything is a circle inside a circle. A circle inside a circle. A circle inside a circle. Amok, amok. There's no end to the circle. Mamash kacha, look how beautiful it is. This is
Kabbalah.
I call circles because everything is by the 10 spirot, the 10 counts of the Kabbalah. Look over here. So we see Pele. Pele is the letters of Aleph. You see, Kizeh Pei, that Pei, and you see a Pei that is open. This is Pele. Mikamocha Ba'alim Hashem. Dear women. So now, let's go and speak about Sefer Yetzirah. Sefer Yetzirah, dear women, the book of creation was considered by, it was written by Avraham Avinu. Avraham Avinu said that God, he created the world first by writing three books. Because you remember, Bereshit bara Elokim et hashamayim ve'et ha'aretz, before there was a creation, God created the letters. Me'alef ad tav. And then there was a, God wrote the Torah, and from the Torah, he was looking at the Torah and creating the world. So look over here, dear women. So he says that there are three books. The first book is the book of Emesh. The three letters, first book, are the three letters, Aleph, Mem, Shin. The second book is Sheva Kfulot, the seven letters that are double. I'll explain it in a minute. And the third book is Shnemasar Lachsonim. Beged Kepet, this is the second book, which is Sheva Kfulot, it's called. Sheva Kfulot, which means seven double. And I'll explain in a minute. The third book is the 12. You see 12 letters? That is left from the Hebrew Aleph Bet?
Yes.
Over here, 12 letters. Shnemasar Lachsonim. This is the 12. Now, the Emesh, it's very important because you'll see when you open the book of Divrei Yamim, this is the last book. You know, the Tanakh includes 24 books. The last book is Divrei Yamim. Okay? This is the last book over there. It starts with Adam. Adam. I wrote that a big. You will see that it starts with Adam Shet Ve'enosh. You remember this is the first human being, but the Aleph is Rabati. The Aleph is big. Ve'divrei Yamim, it opens. If you open it, you will see the Aleph is big. And then, dear women, the Mem. Mem is from Mishlei. Mishlei, again I wrote. Mem is big. The book of Mishlei that wrote King Solomon starts with a big mem. Why a big man? Because King Solomon, it gives indication that he fasted for 40 days in order to receive the wisdom of God. Then we have the Shin. Shin is Shir HaShirim. That wrote King Solomon. It's Shin Rabbati. There are three Shir HaShirim that are from Shlomo HaMelech. The Shin is a big Shin, dear women. And you see Aleph big, Mem big, and Shin big. Remember that Rabbi Akiva said all of the songs are holy, but Shir HaShirim is the holiest of holies. So you see all of them? And look, dear women, we can see even in Mishlei that starts, we have Shem, you see? A name. And we have the Li, that is the word of sanctification between God and the children of Israel. You see it over here? It's beautiful.
According to the Li, there's a connection between Hashem
and God. Yes, you mekudeshet Li betabat zu. You remember that I told you, a man cannot marry a woman that she will be his if he does not say, you're going to be sanctified to me, Li, with this word. He has to say the word Li, otherwise she's not married to him. He has, why? Because God said that we are segula, at least I'm segula Li mikol ha'amim, which means with the word Li, he sanctified the
children of Israel.
In a minute, let me continue, but girls. So we can see that we divided already this. You saw how Aleph turns back, but there's another secret in it. I want you to look. You see over here, when I divided, and you see this is the line of ones, and this is the line of tens, and this is the line of a hundred. But if we will look at the letters, Aleph is one, Yud is ten, one, 10 and 100. We don't add it. Look at it for a minute. Look. I just want you to see. Let's continue. The second is 2, exactly. You see it? 220 and 200. You see? See what's going on? The third one is 330 and 300. The fourth one is 440 and 400. Look how beautiful it is. Then the fifth one is 550 and 500. Then 660 and 600. Then 770 and 700. 880 and 800. And then 990 and 900. Now I want you to, you remember the game that there are three coins? Look, I want you to see. I'm writing them all. Okay, let's go to the game. I want you to see how beautiful it is. I'm just giving you a touch. Okay, let's look at the board. You remember this cube that children play with?
Yes.
Also adults?
Yes.
Yeah, we have the cube over here.
Yes.
That's Baruch Hashem. So let's take the first one. Aleph, Yud, Kuf, okay? This is 1, 10, and 100. And put it inside. Let's go to the second one. Bet, Chaf, Resh, 220, 200. Let's go to the third one. Gimel, Lamed, and Shin. Then we go to Daled, Mem, Vetah. Then we have Hey, Nun, Vechaf. Then we have Vav, Samech, Vemem. After that we have Zayin, Ayin, Venun. And then we have Chet, Pei, Betei, and we have the last one is Tet, Sadi. Look how beautiful it is. All the Hebrew alphabet in 27. And the secret is the 9. You see, everything ends with 9.
Yes.
Okay, if we take it in Gimatria Ktana, you know, it's Mispar Metzumtzam, we'll take off the zeros, everything is 9. Why is it 9? But it's good, let me give you, because I forgot that I don't have the
when
microphone.
When you multiply 9 to 9, again gives you 9.
Your chavid omeret 9 is emet.
9 is truth. Look, it's in small number. Aleph, truth, emet, bereshit. Bereshit, bara, Elohim, dear women,
At the beginning, Bereshit bara Elokim, we have the letters Emet. The end letters of each word is Emet. Aleph is Yud. Aleph is 1, Slicha. Mem is 40. And then Taf is 400, dear women. Let's take off the zeros. We have 4 plus 4 plus 1 equals 9. Yeah. 9 is the number of eternity. But 9 is all Nitzchiyut. 9 is also the number of Adam. Adam, okay. We have Aleph is 1, Dalet is 4, and Mem is 40. Let's take the 0 out of 40. We have 4 plus 4 plus 1 equals 9. How many months is a woman pregnant?
9. ואם הוא נולד לפני זה?
זה משהו אחר, זה תיקונים. This is 9, dear women. This is תיקונים, אבל this is 9. In general, 9 months a woman is pregnant. You see it in the secrets. If I will take the letter Aleph out of them, out of Emet, of truth, and out of the word Adam, the first human being, I will have met, lo alenu, death, and I will have dam, blood.
Wow. So if it happens, then sure, what is it being?
So look what happened. Look at the secrets. Now let's, how do we know that God, it's beautiful, how do we know that God created the world for the children of Israel to study the Torah? If the children of Israel will not keep Shabbat and study the Torah, all of this universe goes back to chaos. שיהיה ברור, it goes back to chaos. How do we know that? It's hidden inside this. Inside this, look how beautiful. So dear women, let's look. Let's look at between Aleph and Dalet. You know, I need to translate at the same time, so sometimes I... Between Aleph and Dalet, how many letters do we have? We have Aleph, Bet, Gimel, 2 letters that are hidden, נכון? So we have over here 2. Letters that are hidden, Bet and Gimel. From Dalet to Zayin, we have Hey, Bab, 2 letters that are hidden. From Bet to Hey, we have Gimel, Dalet, 2 letters that are hidden. From Hey to Chet, we have Bab, Zayin, 2 letters that are hidden. From Gimel to Bab, we have Dalet, Hey, 2 letters that are hidden. From Bab to Tet, we have Bab, Zayin, Chet, 2 letters that are hidden. How many twos do we have?
12.
Which is Yud Bet Alachsonim. Oh, I wiped it. Yud Bet letters that you see, remember that I told you 3 books? Because this is a parallel to the 12 tribes that are going to study the Torah. This is parallel to the 12 months of the year. This is parallel to the 12 constellations. This is parallel to the 12 hours of a day and 12 hours of night, dear women. The 7 letters that are multiplied, those are the letters in Hebrew that gets the Gesh. You know that you can read it Kol or Chol. Okay? They have the Dagesh. When there's a Dagesh inside the letter, which it's strong judgment. When there's no Dagesh, it's softer judgment. You understand? That's why they're called 7 doubles, because they either can get a Dagesh or cannot get a Dagesh. Next lesson we're going to speak about it, because we're going to speak about healing, refuah. So we are going to speak about the Dagesh. And what is the 7? The 7 is the 7 branches of the menorah. Okay? 7 days of creation. 6 days of creation and Shabbat, dear women.
7
days a week. 7 days of creation. 6 days of creation, the 7th is Shabbat, Yishar Koach. Another thing, 7 times of Shemitah. The 7th year is Shemitah. The 50th year is Yovel, dear women.
7 weeks.
Yes, dear women, 7 weeks Shel HaOmer, Sfirat HaOmer, dear women. So we can see, dear women, we can see everything in 7. We can see that in the hidden letters over here, we can see the 12 tribes. And you're not sure it's late. You want me to write something and to show you on the board?
Yes,
okay, Sigi.